Hi everyone, and welcome to this tutorial by For Oxygen Not Included, which is the overview for critters and ranching. And as well as being part of the main tutorial bite series, this is also the introduction video for the critters tutorial bite series. In this video, I'm going to look at critters in general and how to tame them, but I will then go into more detail on each critter's specifics in their own videos. Critters are found naturally around the map, and most aren't dangerous at all. They have many uses, commonly making food or useful resources. Each critter type has a livable temperature range and will die if they are too hot or cold. They also age and have a maximum age before they die. Many critters can also drown if trapped in liquid, which is odd as most don't breathe gases. Dupes can also be ordered to kill critters using the attack command in the bottom right or on the T hotkey. When found on the map, they are wild and most lay an egg before they die of old age, keeping the population stable. But to increase their numbers and get stronger benefits from them, they need to be tamed. Note that not all critters can be tamed though. Taming is done by ranching them in a stable, and first we need to move the critters there. The easiest way to do this is by wrangling them using the wrangle command on the N hotkey. You'll need a dupe with the critter ranching skill to do this, who will then come and wrangle the critter. Any dupe can then take them to a critter drop-off if that critter type is selected from the filter, and the room has fewer than the specified maximum. Many critters can't be wrangled though, so another simple way to move critters is to sweep their eggs into a storage bin, and then drop them. Now once we have critters in a stable, they can be ranched. The stable room only requires the grooming station that can be used by a dupe with the ranching skill. By grooming critters with this station, their wildness will decrease, and once this reaches zero, they become tame. Note that the baby form of critters can't be groomed, so you'll have to wait for them to mature after 5 cycles. Having tamed critters allows us to see useful information on their info card. You can now see their calories and their next egg timing. Their egg reproduction rate will increase hugely compared to a wild critter, allowing us to grow the population if they are fed and groomed. But if not, then usually they will die without producing another egg, so they do need to be looked after. The grooming station will take care of the grooming, and feeding can often be done with the critter feeder building. Simply select the food you want to give your chosen critters, and the dupes will deliver it as long as it's available. You can also use solid shipping to deliver it from elsewhere, and I covered shipping in its own tutorial bite. Making a critter's food source sustainable is a very detailed topic though, and something I will cover in each critter's tutorial. The other bonus of feeding critters is their excretion, which isn't as horrible as it sounds. Most critters will produce a waste product, and this is often a very useful way of converting resources. The product obviously depends on the critter, for example hatches make coal, and this will be covered too in each video. Also, most critters have multiple different food sources, and this can influence the critter morph of laid eggs. A critter morph is like a subspecies of that critter, and has a different appearance, and usually different needs and uses. Hatches have 4 possible morphs, for example, with the basic hatch, sage hatch, stone hatch, and smooth hatch. Of course I'll cover all the morphs in each critter tutorial bite, but you can see in the info card the egg chances for each morph that a critter can lay. This also includes the information on how to influence these egg chances, which may or may not include their food. The other thing to mention about stables is their size, which, like many things in life, does definitely matter. Each critter needs a certain amount of space in a stable to not become cramped or overcrowded. Most commonly this is 12 tiles, so having a maximum room size of 96 tiles will allow you to put 8 critters inside. This is why stables generally need to be this maximum size, but each critter does have its own space requirement. So for this example stable with 8 hatches here, I've made sure it's 96 tiles, which you can check in the room overlay. But these critters are now tame and being groomed and fed. This means they will quite quickly lay new eggs, and once the number of eggs and hatches goes above 8, the hatches will become cramped and stop making any more. Therefore, a really important point of any ranch is quickly removing the extra eggs and dealing with them. You can manually sweep them up with tubes, but for the long term, this really needs to be automated with solid shipping. Stables should generally have auto sweepers and conveyor loaders to remove these extra eggs. This works well with the automated feeding too. Now we're generating a lot of extra eggs, so let's have a look at them in more detail. Firstly, you can crack these in the egg cracker and cook them into omelets, but this is generally not as effective as hatching them for meat. Eggs have an incubation timer before they hatch, which is commonly 20 cycles or a rate of 5% per cycle. Beware that eggs also have a viability, and this will decrease if left in a container. If this reaches zero, the egg will break into raw egg, so be careful when manually sweeping them. To hatch eggs more quickly, incubators and cuddle pips can be used. Cuddle pips are simple, and if they cuddle an egg, then the incubation rate is increased by 5% for one cycle. Incubators are more powerful still, allowing ranchers to lullaby the eggs, giving a plus 20% incubation rate for one cycle. This does stack with the cuddle pip buff to hatch them very quickly indeed. Incubators are made of refined metal, and once made you can choose which egg to incubate. They are also very power hungry, requiring 240 watts each. But they only need to be powered to get the lullaby buff, so automation is commonly used to significantly reduce power draw. A simple way to do this uses a timer sensor in groups of 4, set to 60 seconds on and 600 seconds off. This gives the dupes 60 seconds to lullaby the eggs, and the incubators are set to priority 9. Then the incubator will turn off for a cycle to save power. Doing it this way also allows all the incubators to be connected to the same transformer, but you may need to manually reset them to make sure more than 4 aren't on at the same time for a normal transformer. But the best way to automate them is with filter and buffer gates and a weight plate. This works by detecting when a dupe lullabies the egg, standing on the plate for more than 5 seconds. Then the circuit is activated, but still held green by the second filter gate for 10 seconds to allow them to finish. The buffer gates here then turn off the incubator for a cycle to save the power. I'm showing the gates spread out here for clarity. But of course they can be packed in more tightly. When the egg does hatch, it will make a baby form of the critter, which will then take 5 cycles to mature into an adult that can produce more eggs. From the incubators, these critters can be moved by dupes to a critter drop-off if the filter is set, even if the critter can't normally be wrangled. Hatching eggs also has the benefit of making the eggshell resource, which can be used in the rock crusher to make lime, and then steel. Ranching critters is therefore a great way of generating a lot of sustainable lime. Be aware that the amount of lime produced by crushing one eggshell depends on the critter, but generally they make 2 kilograms per egg. That means hatching 2.5 eggs will make enough lime for 100 kilograms of steel. Using incubators is generally my preferred way of dealing with eggs. It is possible to come up with complex automation to drop eggs into ranches at the right time, but I don't use these and they are difficult to explain. So with this concept, the auto sweeper takes the eggs out of the ranches and drops them here. Dupes will then supply the incubators as a priority to replace any critters that die in the stables. Note here that incubators should not be placed inside ranches, as the eggs will still be counted. Critters hatched in incubators will automatically be taken to a correctly configured drop-off. Set this to accept the baby type of the critter and the maximum depending on the critter requirement, but usually 8. This keeps the ranch full and at maximum production. For incubator numbers, I would aim for around 1 incubator per 8 critter ranch. Generally though, we end up hatching more critters here than we need to replace. To deal with the extras, I would recommend using another critter drop-off set to a lower priority to place the excess. Here I'm showing this room and the room the eggs are being dropped into, which itself will hatch unincubated eggs, just as empty rooms as a placeholder. Dealing with these will be different for each critter, and I'll cover these in each of the critter videos. Commonly, drowning chambers are used to make meat, which is why they also have a nicer name of evolution chambers, where they evolve into meat. Note that the live critters do need to be moved away from this overflow drop-off to be dealt with, as it will max out at 20. And that's everything there is to cover in general about critters. To help with each critter type as a summary, I've produced this summary table here, which is in two parts. I won't go through this in detail, as each critter will be covered in their own videos, with all this information and more. So that's all for now. I hope you enjoy the series and find it helpful, and thanks for watching.